R.I.PRESENTS
Sea People Mountain People Chapter 1 Previous Overview Ryoji received a large amount of Hanasaki crab from the hostess at an inn in Kushiro, and after finishing his meal while soaking in the emotion, he fell asleep immediately that day. When he woke up in the light of the next morning, the time was a little past 7 o'clock, and it was a cold morning with white breath. As soon as he woke up, he turned on the oil fan heater, wrapped a blanket around his body and stayed still, realizing that he had eaten a lot yesterday, but by the morning he was already hungry. When the room warmed up a little, he ate yesterday's crab and fried chicken. After breakfast, he calmed down and thought about his plans for today. In the land of Kushiro, what he had always been interested in was food and wetlands. However, the sea and the mountain are familiar, but the image of the wetlands does not float at all. Because of the unknown, adventure is a man's romantic. Since he had come to Kushiro, he decided to go to the marshland. After that, the action was early, it prepared for departure, it left the room, it thanked the female host, it left the inn, and it got into the car to go to the destination. For the purpose of heading to Kushiro wetlands. He started the car and immediately tried to find the way to the Kushiro marshland, but since this was the first place he had visited, he did not know the way. Kushiro Wetlands is famous, so he thought there would be a guide board and started driving, but contrary to his thoughts, he could not find it even if he searched. When he asked a passerby for directions to the moor, he told him that there was a sign for the Animal Protection Center along Route 53, and that if you turn right there, you will find the nearest observatory. He said a thank you and driving the car, but in fact, he learned of the existence of observation deck for the first time. In his mind, he reflected a little on himself for acting without any investigation. And as he was driving, as he was told by passers-by, he was relieved to see a sign that said 53. After a while, a sign appears indicating the direction of the observatory and the Marsh Wildlife Conservation Center, and he follows the sign and turns right. Then all he have to do is drive straight. Then, on the right, a landscape that looked like a marshland came into view. At first, first glance, it looked like an ordinary grassland, but as he drove around thinking it was the edge of the marsh, he saw a facility labeled the Marsh Wildlife Conservation Center. Showed a little interest in the facility, but when he passed the place, the road ahead was a normal road. As he driving a little further, he saw a signboard of the Hokuto ruins on the right side of the road. Normally, he was not interested in history at all, but this signboard was something worrisome, and when he looked at it a little, he turned the steering wheel to the right and turned the car to the Hokuto ruins. He moved the car a little and found that the paved road had become a gravel road, and as he went further, the road split in two. He hesitated for a moment as to which way to go, stopped the car just before the fork in the road, and then intuitively selected the left road and drove again. As he drove on, the road was wide enough at first, but gradually narrowed until it became wide enough for only one car. At this point, he finally realized that he had made a mistake, but there was no space around him to make a U-turn, so he had no choice but to move forward and see what was going on. After driving for about 5 minutes, the road suddenly disappeared and a slightly open meadow appeared. The moment he parked the car in front of the grassland and looked out over the grassland, Ryoji opened his eyes wide, his face turned pale, and he felt something running on his back. Today's story ends. I'll update tomorrow next time. Please look forward to. Please subscribe to the channel. See you again.